Good morning, Yellow Creek. I want to welcome you to the midweek service. I want to thank Jacob Holtze, Megan, Kate, and Becca for coming out and singing, for Bryce for all that he done to prepare the sound system for this service. Hope this time finds everybody feeling well and doing good. I know that we're getting more bad news day to day, and we just felt like it'd be a good time to get together and sing a little songs and share the gospel with you in midweek. I do have a little scripture I want to read this morning. And if you have your Bibles and want to read with me, I'm going to be in the book of John. This is very familiar scripture to everybody. I know that, like I've already said, when you watch the news, when you begin to listen to everything that's said, it's real easy for us to get troubled and to begin to worry about maybe what the count's going to be tomorrow, or how high the numbers are going to be, or what the death count is from the coronavirus today. And I'm so thankful that in God's Word we can find comfort. And today that's just six little verses that I want to leave with you that I hope will comfort your heart. In the book of John, chapter 14, the Bible says in verse number 1, "Let your hearts not be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go prepare a place for you, and if I go prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And whether I go, you know, and the way you know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." And this morning, as I thought about those verses and I thought about the good songs of Zion that we heard sung, I began to think about a prepared place. And I'm so thankful that Jesus himself has made us the promise that he's gone to prepare us a place. And in that prepared place, if you've been saved by God's marvelous grace, we're going to a place where there is no coronavirus. We're going to a place where there is no cancer. We're going to a place where there is no separation, where we'll all get to be together in heaven with Jesus Christ. And he's made us this promise in his word that if he goes to prepare that place, that he will come again. And I'm thankful this afternoon or this morning that we know that he is coming again. And I pray that your whole house is prepared for when Jesus comes back. I pray that if you're not prepared, and you may be saying, "Preacher, well, I'm not prepared. I don't really know what to do." I just ask, if wherever you're at right now, that you would kneel down. If you feel that tug down in your heart and you know that you're lost and you know that you need Jesus, my prayer is that you would kneel down and ask him to be your personal Savior right where you're at. Because Jesus said he went to prepare a place. And some 2,000 years ago, he prepared that place when he went to the cross of Calvary, when he shed his precious blood for whosoever will. Ever since then, that place has been prepared that we might be saved, that we might be able to accept Jesus as our personal Savior. So this morning, as the Bible said in verse number 1, "Let your hearts not be troubled." If you've been saved by God's marvelous grace, I pray that you'll put your trust in him, you'll put your faith in him, and not be troubled with all that's going on in this world, because it's not caught Jesus by surprise. He knows where we're at. He knows what we're facing. And he knows when this storm is going to be over. He knows when the last case is going to be tested. But more than that, he knows when that of the last soul is going to be saved. And I pray that today you'll accept Jesus as your personal Savior, and that you'll be prepared to go to that place that he's prepared for us. So until next time, I hope that all of you are well. I hope that everything's going good. I hope that you enjoy the singing. And again, I want to thank all of those that come out to sing in Yellow Creek. I just ask that you be much in prayer for all of the prayer requests that you know that's out there. I pray that you be much in prayer for those that are lost and undone. So we'll close in a word of prayer now. Our most kind and gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, I want to thank you for this day and for all of our many blessings. God, I thank you for the songs that we were able to hear sung. God, I pray that you would reach out and touch those that are lost. God, I pray that you would save them in their homes, God, before we are even allowed to come back to church, God. But, God, I just want to ask that you would be with all of those that are on the front lines that are helping to fight that of this coronavirus. Lord, I just pray that you would be with them, you'd be with their families. God, I pray that you protect them in all that they do. And Lord, I just ask that you would be with our president and with all of them that's in the White House, Lord, that God, that you might be with them. And you'd give them the wisdom, God, to seek you out before they make any decisions. God, I know that it has to be a heavy burden, but Lord, I just pray that you would give them the wisdom to do that. That might be pleasing to you, and that, God, that it would be able to trickle down to your people and then down to your churches and down, God, to those that need it, Lord. And I just pray now that you would go with us, lead, guide, and direct us, and it's everything, God, that we do. And, Lord, I pray that, God, as we come upon Easter, God, I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know where we're going to be, but, Lord, I want to thank you so much for that resurrection morning. And God, if it be your will, God, I pray that a way would be made that your people would be able to come together. And God, a way would be made that would be we would be able to gather together on Resurrection Sunday and celebrate, God, Easter one more time. And God, I just ask that you would go with us. God, I know that there's a lot that's sick. I know that there's a lot that's worried. But God, right now my heart breaks for those that are lost and undone. God, they're in more dire need than those that are facing corona or facing anything else. God, I pray that salvation would come to them. And God, I just ask that you would be with all of our sister churches and all of the deacons and all of the pastors, God, that God, they would seek you out in this time, Lord, and that you would give them the messages, God, that they need for their flock also. And Lord, we'll ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Because he loves you.